Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Ellern. I'm a cosmetic physician here at Reflections, and today we are talking about tattoo removal. So tattoo removal has advanced over this period of time, and today we're going to go through the advances that have come about in the last couple years that have made tattoo removal easier than ever. So, did you know that over 70 million people have tattoos, and over half of them are considering removal? So there's some things that have made tattoo removal more complex over the years, including the advent of more semi-permanent makeup, microblading, and the like. Those tattoos can be sometimes easier and sometimes more challenging depending on the type of ink and the materials that are used in them. So you really need to go to a place that has a number of different lasers that can be utilized for removal, and also providers who know how to deal with different types of ink, different colors of ink, and when we should and should not remove them. Different inks can have different responses when we hit them with lasers. Some of them can change color, such as white tattoo ink. Some of them can be harder to remove than others. So we just need to evaluate the type of tattoo you have and kind of find out what the history of it is, as much as you're able to provide, and determine if this tattoo is able to be removed. So we are able to remove pretty much any size tattoo. We may, if it's large enough, decide to split it into separate sittings just for the sake of, you know, ease both of the patient, the ability to numb a larger tattoo, or just the recovery afterwards. Because the bigger and the more ink, the more attraction the laser has and the more, you know, downtime you may have of swelling, especially if it's on a limb like the arm. Little tattoos are much quicker. They will take mere seconds to remove. We will injection numb them if you're nervous about the discomfort of it, because it can feel like hot grease splatter when you're doing it. It's fairly uncomfortable. So numbing it is a way to get through it to make it a little easier. We have a couple different tattoo lasers that we can utilize. So when we're deciding what tattoo laser to use, we have to look at the color, the response, how much ink's in there, what our goals are, and we come up with a stepwise plan. If it's a multicolor tattoo, we have to utilize one type of laser and one type of setting first to tone down some of the darkness, some of the blackness in it, and then move on to starting to pick off some of the individual colors. There is more advancements to help move these things along quicker as time has gone on. There's ways to clear some of the frosting that occurs, which is the water that comes up to the surface of skin that creates a white haze over the tattoo after it's treated, which you will see if you watch a lot of tattoo removal videos. That can help be cleared out, and we can do multiple passes depending on the amount of ink and the response. So tattoo removal has been advancing fairly quickly over the years. The laser that we utilize mainly is the PQ4. It's the highest power picosecond laser on the market. It has two different wavelengths in it. It has an ND-AG 1064 and a 532. Works really well. Picoseconds actually fire more rapidly than a traditional nanosecond laser. What that does is creates a vibrational effect that will help break the ink particles up even more effectively than just laser alone. So it actually will help clear the ink out. The way that tattoo removal works is that we're using lasers to break these particles, and the smaller we can break them and the more readily we can break them, the faster it'll clear out from your body. Tattoo removal can be done every 6 to 8 weeks, and the clearing of the ink takes around 3 months. So you can do them more frequently than the ink is clearing, just to try and keep it moving along. And we will analyze how many treatments you need based on what your tattoo looks like, how big it is, how many colors, that sort of thing. So when we are talking about tattoo removal, we're actually aiming the laser into your skin, and professional tattoo artists who are good will have a very consistent, even pressure when they're placing the tattoo on there. That's what, you know, the steady hand, the even application, that's what makes things look really nice. So that ink will be laid out in a very consistent pattern at a particular depth within your skin. When you're talking about ones that are done non-professionally, that can vary as to the depth, and that can be a challenge when removing it because the ink can be very close to the surface or it could be very deep. We do remove home done tattoos as well, but we would analyze yours and see what's going on. When we are talking about both professional and non-professional, there can be some scarring that occurred to the skin during the process of having the tattoo put on. So when we are looking at the skin, we may have to use some of our other lasers that are not our picosecond PQ4 or our Q-switch Ruby or Q-switch Alex that we traditionally use. We may have to go to resurfacing lasers. Some of the resurfacing lasers that we utilize can be our Fraxel Restore and Repair. One is a non-ablative fractionated laser, and one is an ablative one that's a little more aggressive. What that's doing is actually resurfacing those scars and allowing the ink particles that are trapped within those scars to be released with that. People have done some tattoo removal by questionable methods at home, and that can create scarring too. So if you are trying to have a tattoo removal, it's best to have it done by professionals that know what they're doing, who use caution and care to remove this as to not create a secondary problem when you're doing your tattoo removal. So what is new in tattoo removal upcoming? So we are using PFD, which helps to clear some of the whiteness out. That can allow us to do multiple passes, and that's becoming more and more part of the regimen, especially as we get to the end of the tattoo removal cycle for patients. There's also an acoustic shockwave technology that's coming out slated later this year that's to be used with some of the lasers that we already employ to help move along this process even more quickly. So keep posted if you're interested in that. We probably will have a video when we are able to acquire that technology. So why come to Reflections versus going somewhere else? I think the most important thing whenever you're deciding where to go is having people who do this all the time, who know how to utilize the technology, who have the technology, who have the experience to know when to treat, to know when not to treat, even more so than anything else, and to problem shoot as we go along and make sure that we are correcting the issues that we need to correct, treating the problems that we need to treat, and removing the tattoo as quickly and efficiently as possible so you can get back to your regular life and enjoy your tattoo-free body however you choose. So if you have found this video helpful, please give it a like, and if you would like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel.